Hello, and welcome to another video in the Scriptcase Macros course. Today, we're going to be looking at some variables that are part of the macros that are the query where variables. So these are variables for managing and controlling the state of your where statements. The first one is the scWhere orig. So this is the original where statement of a grid before any alterations are made either by the user or by the code that you wrote as the programmer. The next one is the scWhere current. So this is what the where is currently set to. So it returns the current where cause. And so those are our variables that we need. So let's go ahead and look at the documentation for those. So there's our where current and where orig. And all we need to do is put them in the curly braces. So that tells us what they do. And you put them in the curly braces and it will return it just like any other variable. And there's the scope for where it can be used. Now let's go back up and find the next one, the where orig. So there's where current, and then click where orig right here. So this is done in much the same way. You can put it inside the curly braces and it will tell you the original where query. So let's go over the script case here. Here I have a grid set up, just a basic grid. Let me go ahead and run it so you can see what it looks like. So I've got some different records here, and I've also got a refined search over here. So this refined search, the reason I'm using it is because as I click elements on this, it'll edit the variables, the applications where clause. So then we can see those changes as they're done throughout the processing. So first, let's go to the event and on script init. And let's start with the where orig. Let's go ahead and get that where orig value now. So let's copy it. And we're going to put it inside the curly braces like it says to do. So grab it all and then copy it right here. And I'm going to put it equal to a variable here, so orig where. Make sure I format it correctly. So orig where is going to equal our scWhere orig macro variable. So now I'm just going to pop on an alert that tells us what that was. So I just need to make sure that I get the semicolon after that so it works correctly. And let's go ahead and run this and see where it is. So it's not going to pop up anything at first because we haven't set an original where yet. So as you can see, it just pops up an empty box with an OK button. So let's go ahead and set an original where. So to do that, let me go ahead and close. So to do that, we need to go to the SQL section here. Click on that. And there's our SQL select statement. Let's put a where after it here. So it's just going to be a where 1 equals 1. So this is just kind of a basic one, but it will pop it up so we can use it for demonstration purposes. So I run this and there it is. So there's our where clause, right? Like so, like we would expect. So now let's look at what happens when we modify this. So this is going to need the scWhere current macro variable now. So let's go ahead and go to the documentation here and find that macro. So there it is, our where current, click on that. So that's how we use it. Let's go ahead and copy that now. And we use it very similarly over here. So we're going to create a new variable here with the dollar sign current where equals our scWhere current like so. And now we can pop up that when it changes. So I'm going to copy that into our alert here and go ahead and run this, and this should work as is. So it's going to pop up the current where, which is also the original where. Let's go ahead and select special features. And there is our new where statement there showing what was different. If I click another language ID, it's editing the where again. So that way we can see what the new where is. Let's go ahead and combine these now. So I'm going to do both of them. So this is kind of useful if you want to do some troubleshooting. So I'm going to first display the original where and concatenate that together with the original where, like so. And then I'm going to put a new line inside of that alert box. And in that is going to be the current where. So tell the user that it's the current where with a semicolon, space, and put the current where right after that, concatenate it together, and get rid of that extra space there. And this should work so we can see what the difference between the original and the current where is. So let's go ahead and run this. So right now they're both the same because we haven't made any modifications. Let's click OK. Now let's make a modification. So there we go. So there we can track easily what the difference between the current and the new where is, the current and the original is, as we make those changes. So that's how you use the scWhere variables to track changes between the where clauses throughout an application's runtime.